on, and you can see 53 seconds at the moment, I think. The moment somebody puts in an attack over the peloton, we will see that dropping off, you know, 10, 15, 20 seconds in a kilometre on this steep section we're going to. And this Mutiny, this is the killer. If anybody puts in a big dig here, this will blow this group apart. And we can see what we got, 50 riders, so we've lost a huge amount of riders out of the peloton.
176 riders still in the Tour de France. There's Simon Yates holding on at the back. The gentleman you saw in the blue jersey coming to the front and into Champagne was Dries Deveneins, the Belgian rider from De Koenig Quickstep, working to make this harder and select that group even more for Julien Alaphilippe. There's Daniel Oss, who's done his job for the day, the Italian rider for Bora Hansgrohe. Number 75 at the back in a blue jersey is Gorka Izagirre, and number 15 on there with him, you can see Jesus Herrada. De Koenig Quickstep and Astana working hard, and well, this is a surprise to see that's Laporte, in fact, towards the back being dropped. Not so much of a surprise. Hoekman moving up on the left-hand side. Ineos following these moves as well. Geraint Thomas is there alongside Egan Bernal, who waits and waits for things to kick off. Bernal sitting in about fifth position at the moment. This is Omar Fraile now, Tour de France stage winner in Monde last year. And Dries Deveneins has done. Oh, Tony Gallopin has done as well. Well, that shows how hard it is. Alaphilippe at the front. He wants to be there, but probably not just yet. Look at Wout van Aert. Look at how Wout van Aert is surviving here, and he is a candidate to take the yellow jersey.
Yes, he is, and he's looking good to be up here. We can see here a lot of the big men here for the general classification start to appear there, and any little bit of a just up in pace, a little bit, it causes gaps there. We could see there was a little bit of a gap start to appearing.
Yep, gaps everywhere now. And Peter Sagan, though, in the green jersey, is following wonderfully well. This is the two-time Kazakhstan national champion, Alexei Lutsenko. And that is Ilnur Zakarin. Simon Yates, we know, is not riding GC here. And this could perhaps be an indicator that Ilnur Zakarin isn't doing either. Well, he's just come out the Giro d'Italia, as we see a look around from Tim Wellens. And I think, Sean, your prediction might be about to be coming true. He looks round and he can see them already behind. The gap is disappearing into thin air. Wellens is giving his all on the final classified climb of the day. But it looks like it's going to be such a tough ask. There's movement as Ineos send a couple of riders to the front. Kwiatkowski on the left-hand side now, as for the first time Sagan loses a wheel or two. Wellens swinging left to right at the top, being willed on by the legions of fans, though. And the yellow jersey, Mike Turnerson, still trying to hang on. Oh, here he is! All hail King Alaphilippe! Turns up in front of his subjects to attack. And this might be the moment that they really do have to follow. It's Wellens who's taken back. It's Alaphilippe who's going to come across behind and take second place over the top. 8 bonus seconds and a King of the Mountains jersey for Tim Wellens. 5 there. Oh, and it's a mechanical. It's a problem. It's a mechanical. And if you think back to the front and the start of the climb, Wellens had his hand up. So you were wondering if that mechanical problem has persisted with him throughout the whole climb, Sean.
Yes, it looks like, as we can see here,
Turnerson
getting dropped here. But yeah, Wellens probably, maybe a tyre going down slowly, but he continued on there and he got to where he wanted to be.
That's more mechanical problem this time for Eddie Gilbert, the rider in the white jersey on the right-hand side who'd stopped. But it's Mike Turnerson who at the moment is losing the yellow jersey, maybe. Julien Alaphilippe, by the way, if he wants the yellow jersey, has to take 31 seconds on the man on your screen. Oh, and he's riding away wonderfully well right now. Nobody's gone with him, Sean.
No, nobody, I think, able to go with him at the moment. He put in the attack there, and Alaphilippe, we know he's capable of going for a long one, and he struck out. Will he be good enough? Will he be strong enough to hold on there? Because we still have a lot of firepower in the peloton, but yeah, a lot of teams here, they have lost, a number of men, so the general classification men, sometimes, they don't have enough teammates around to organise the chase. But Alaphilippe, that was a big attack there, at a moment when everybody was, I think, on the limit.
One man I didn't see in that group was Mikel Landa. Valverde was there alongside Quintana. No Mikel Landa at that precise moment. This is the moment that Alaphilippe went away. Bernal and Thomas not following. Lutsenko looking behind and not seeing Fuglsang either. athlete knows this. He's reconned these roads. He will be going for the stages. Remember last year, he was swashbuckling as he went away and took the King of the Mountains jersey. He's picked up his first points in that competition here. Just a single point. But it's all about the stage win today. Now then, was Mikel Landa towards the back of that group? That's something to keep an eye on. Mike Tournesen still working hard. And his team was alongside Kraasvek and Bennett and Wout van Aert towards the end. Number 147 was Søren Kral out of the way and I think suffering a mechanical problem in the red. Kilometers to go. One more unclassified climb too. And it's 38 seconds already for Julien Alaphilippe ahead of the yellow jersey. Now what is the distance to the peloton? At the moment, Alaphilippe is the virtual maillot jaune, the virtual leader of the race, as we see Mikel Landa off the front. Now that's why we didn't see Landa in that group. He's off the front, so it's better news than we thought. Just behind him, number 98 there is Mike Woods. We also saw Max Schachmann in the mix as well. Well, champagne special, we know that. It can produce bike racing too. So some really interesting things to factor in with that chasing group being as good as it is, because Movistar are represented, Bora Hansgrohe are represented, and of course we can see that Astana have representation alongside EF Education first. Who's going to chase it? Jumbo-Visma has to be.
Well, we have the picture here. It's Jumbo-Visma who have to take up the chase here and continue on. And Alaphilippe, of course, speaking in the paper today, he had lost a lot more time in the team times than he expected. He was hoping that bit closer, and at 21 seconds, he wants to get the yellow jersey. That's what he talked about at the beginning of this race. So he has to maybe strike out early and try and take more time. But is he gone out too early? Will he be able to hold on? But looking good at the moment, 31 seconds we can see here back to... That he's back to the peloton, I reckon. It cannot be back to the yellow jersey because he's...
It looked like he was losing time, didn't he?
He was quite a bit further back.
That looks like a graphical error, but we'll wait to confirm it. In the meantime, Mike Woods in the pink, Mikel Landa Meana in the blue. Good news for Movistar that he was in front of the race rather than behind it. There's a tailwind as well, helping Alaphilippe here too. All these things will have been calculated and taken into account. Julien Alaphilippe riding his third Tour de France, looking for a yellow jersey for the first time. He's the number one cyclist in the world now, though. Peter Sagan still in this group. And the yellow jersey, Mike Tournesen, has one rider in front of him from Cofidis, and that rider is Julien Simon. Simon, who was declassified on the first stage for an irregular sprint at some point. Tournesen will ride, will give it all. The power of the yellow jersey can sometime produce something very special. Graphics are saying he's 35 seconds back, though. Landa rides here, and they're just making Jumbo-Visma look that bit much harder to try and keep it. And the way this has been ridden, with 10.5 kilometres to go, the finale still to go, we could see little bits of differences everywhere.
Yes, well, we can see difference on the run-up to the finish here. We will see gaps in the peloton, and that is something where all the general classification men will be really pushing big time to get into the final couple of 100 metres in a good position, because if you're too far off, if you're back in 30th position, they're going to be riders who are not able to follow the stronger ones up front, and they will gaps appear. And you take 10, 15 seconds, even on this short ramp of a couple of 100 metres to the line, you can lose 15 seconds so quickly.
Short ramp up to the line. Ooh, do you know what? I think that time gap might be right. He's not too far behind the peloton now.
He's getting back and he's fighting bravely.
10 kilometres to go on what has been a brilliant stage 3 of the Tour de France so far. We started in Belgium, in Banche, in the French-speaking area. We're heading into Champagne. Michael Matthews must be feeling okay as well, because Team Sunweb are committing to chase here. And the yellow jersey now, 1 minute and 15 seconds from Julien Alaphilippe. He said he was fighting. I'm not sure how much is left, though. Alaphilippe riding away well here. Now, what's the gap to the next group? What is the gap to the peloton?
race radio 50 seconds we're hearing there, and it looks like that group out in front has been pulled back in here. So that is, I think, 116, 180, 120 at the moment back to the yellow jersey, but 50 seconds over the race radio back to this main peloton of favourites.
Is that it? Does Alaphilippe have the stage?
Well, it's looking good. Just 8.8 to go, and we can see there the Visma Jumbo just trying to keep the pace high. Sunweb also getting involved there. It's going to be a difficult one to see that they can, you know, get enough men here to have that power to pull back Alaphilippe, because, you know, he is going to ride his, you know, set to standstill, and you know, he has that advantage when he gets down to the final climb, that if he really struggles, still he could be able to hold on. If he has this going into the final couple of 100 metres, the ramp up to the line, well then he is secure.
Two Tour de France stage victories last year. And we're heading to Epernay for the first time since 1963, when it was Eddie Bowles who won from a four-man breakaway, including the great Federico Bahamontes. Big chase on for Jumbo-Visma. That's Laurens de Plus. Darrell Impey hanging around while Fanart is there as well. As it stands, with the gap as it is, Alaphilippe would not only be winning the stage, he would be going into the yellow jersey as Ineos get organised on the left-hand side. They have decided this is the time to keep their man safe.
Yes, well, that is the problem for Alaphilippe here. There's going to be some of the GC teams, notably Ineos, who have a number of riders. They're going to ride in the final just to play safe. It's not Alaphilippe is their main concern. Their concern is to keep Geraint Thomas and Bernal in the best position possible. That means in the very front of the peloton. So put a few riders, just drive it on with the final number of kilometres and get them onto the real steep part of the finish up to the line here. And that's where Alaphilippe could suffer, but still he's looking good, and the advantage he has is still, you know, quite a big one.
One more climb to go for Julien Alaphilippe. It isn't classified, there are no points, but for him it's all about everything on the line at the end. Now Jonathan Castroviejo is the man who's riding at the front. He's about to have company as well from CCC team. Around a minute is the gap. This is the virtual general classification. We know that Mike Tournison is going to be saying goodbye to the yellow jersey at the end of the day. Alaphilippe, if the stage were to finish right now, would be leading by 29 seconds from Van Aert, Bennett and Carlsvig, Tournison's teammates. Well, we know he's flying, but he hasn't finished yet. Julien Alaphilippe looking for win number 29 in his career. This year has been his best ever year, without doubt. First one very early on indeed in January in Argentina. He went on to win in Colombia. He was victorious at Strade Bianche. He won two stages in Tirreno. He won Milano San Remo and is now a monument winner. He won in the Basque Country, Flèche Wallonne, and came back to winning ways at the Dauphiné. Can he do it again at the Tour de France and take the yellow jersey? Final climb still to come. 6.5 kilometres on the way to Epernay. The first day of the new bonus sprints added extra spice to things. But it's Julien Alaphilippe, the man we were all waiting for today, who's gone away and has taken 42 seconds on the chasing peloton. He has 1 minute 50 on the yellow jersey. The yellow jersey, Mike Tournison, will cease to be so in 6 kilometres time. This is the man leading. A phenomenon. A man from France who excelled in cyclocross as a youngster. Last year catapulted to stardom as the king of the mountains, the darling of French cycling. He's a class act, isn't he?
Well, he's a super bright brother, and you know, last year we see him when he got into the breakaways, just able to finish it off. A big mountain stages, let's not forget, and winning stages and taking the polka dot jersey all the way to Paris. But you know, this year already, what, roughly about 10 wins, and when you look at the ones he have won, like a Milan San Remo, Flèche Wallonne, Strade Bianche, they're major ones, and you know, of recent as well. He came back there in the Dauphiné, won there, had that rest period after the Classics, and now, you know, hitting out there at that time, I think it surprised everybody when he struck out, because I think a lot of people were thinking, well, this is going to be all about the finish up to the line here, the final couple of hundred metres. But Alaphilippe, we know he's just out of rider. He was attacked from a long ways out.
That's not good news, though, because the neutral service car disappears up ahead of him. The only thing I can say here is that it's narrow roads. It's very, very difficult, maybe, for it to move out once they're on the climb.
Yeah, so maybe some of the neutral cars are in between with that breakaway as well, so maybe they were just, kept behind for a time and then move ahead. But we can see
there's a motorbike there.
Yes, there's a motorbike here. We can see something. Is it another yellow car just a bit further back?
Dan Martin there, Nairo Quintana, Adam Yates, Vincenzo Nibali, all the main stars are there. And it's been a good ride too from both Edvard Boasenhagen and from Peter Sagan. Number 133 is Giulio Ciccone. 91 there, Rigoberto Urán, and this, with 5 kilometers to go, is Julian Alaphilippe. The number one bike rider in the world. He's recently signed a brand new contract to stay with the Koenig Quickstep. Last year, the team won 4 stages at the Tour de France. 2 for this man, 2 for Gaviria. Gaviria briefly held the yellow jersey. It was the polka dots at the end. And a celebration, if I remember him standing on the top of a car, very much in Brad Wiggins style at the end in Paris. Ineos still at the front. Wout Poels alongside Dylan van Baarle and company. Poels is who hits the front now. 4.5 kilometres remaining. Gap's gone down to 34 seconds though.
Yes.
And Alaphilippe, well, he might be looking all right for the stage if he can keep this rhythm up. But the yellow jersey starts to slip away because, remember, he has to take an extra 10 seconds back.
Yes, it's getting... It's getting difficult for Alaphilippe. We can see him here. He's just struggling. And when he went away first, he was looking real power there. But he can do that for a number of kilometres. And then it can start to catch you a bit. And also in the peloton, we can see there's a number of teams just coming to the front there, pushing it on a bit. 4.2 to go. Yeah, it's still no. There's no guarantee that he's going to hold on.
And here are EF Education First riding their hearts out as well. 17 seconds now on the virtual general classification. 31 on the road. Alaphilippe out of the saddle, working hard. And you can imagine behind, they're fighting for position too for the bottom of this climb and those narrow ropes. They're trying to keep all their GC riders very, very safe. And rather cruelly, this one continues to snake up before dropping very quickly down into Epalmé. But it's not done yet, is it, once they get there? There's a rectangle around the town. There's some cobbles with about 1.5 kilometres to go, a couple of narrow chicanes and things like that, and then towards the end, you've got those 500 metres to the line above 8%. And look at Peter Sagan, he's looking the best we've seen him for quite a while.
Yes, he's looking comfortable there and just staying to the front of the peloton and just waiting, and he'll be hoping that there's more teams there will continue on to push and just give them acceleration on the front of the peloton. And he's where we would expect him to be, although we're saying would it be just that little bit too difficult for him on the climbs before the finish, but he looks to be getting through quite well.
There's the maillot jaune, the heel of true, as it's been for the last couple of days, the Dutch translation of the yellow jersey. And as they're almost at the top of the hill, he's only starting it.
Yes, and you can see Zakarin there also, which is a rider you'd expect to be able to stay in that group of main contenders for the general classification.
Julian Alaphilippe with 35 seconds on the chasing peloton as he descends like a demon into Epernay. The first finish here since 1963, and the big bottles of the local brew are waiting. Alaphilippe with 3 kilometres to go, 35 seconds of a gap. He's looking okay again.
Yes, he's looking good here, and he's going down at a real fast rate. We can see 70 kilometres per hour, and he can do that. We've seen him in the Milan Sanremo, for example, going down to the Poggio. He's able to do this. He's a talented rider. Going downhill, he's
no fear at all.
He's a real good descender, and he's not losing anything here, I think, to the peloton at the moment. Because again, the team who's riding the front, if Ineos is riding the front, they're not going to ride at breakneck speed and risk having a crash with some of the leaders in front of their leaders. So they will get down at a good pace, would not take any major risks. So that's where Alaphilippe will probably pull out the advantage. We can see 35 hopping out to 37. Yeah, it depends on how much he has left in the tank, because the run up to the line, if you really asked out to get MC, well, you could lose a lot of time on the final number of metres.
He's into that rectangle around town, but it finishes on a hill on a housing estate, actually, just overlooking the centre of town. 1.9 kilometres to go, 35 seconds for the Frenchman, who delighted the home fans last year with his swashbuckling performances. It could be another chapter in the history of his legend today, but he has to finish it off. 1.7 kilometres to go, and they're chasing on behind. It's Michał Kwiatkowski, the world champion from Ponferrada in 2014, who's leading the chase. Daryl Impey there towards the back, number 34, riding for Agir d'Azur is Matthias Frank, but we're concerned with the man who turns onto the cobbles. The Flamme Rouge is up ahead, 400 metres further down the road. He has a good gap here, and it's not really changing, Sean.
No, it's not, and it's not not surprising, it's not changing the way we see him going downhill there. And now we're into a section, yeah, here, this is a difficult one, on the cobbles, you know, when you've been given that big effort there, the peloton can go so much faster. Will there be riders who will really push on here in this long straight here as we go to the Flamme Rouge? But yeah, still that 34, 35 second advantage. If he can keep it going up this final run to the line, well, then he should be able to take the stage victory, but it's going to be real close for the yellow jersey.
The grit of the teeth, the show is being put on by cycling's number one showman at the moment. 900 metres for Julien Alaphilippe after 4 hours and 40 minutes of tough, very tough riding indeed, starting in Belgium. They've all come to acclaim their hero, and it looks as though he's going to be able to pull it off. Another look around for Alaphilippe, but he's got those final 500 metres still to go. Now the peloton heading towards 1 kilometre to go. Who's riding here? It's Ineos on the right-hand side as we look at it. Nobody from Jumbo Visma. And it's not only a stage win that Alaphilippe is looking for, it is the famed yellow jersey of the Tour de France. 100 years after it was first used, and it's going to go back on French shoulders, maybe. Julien Alaphilippe, as the road starts to rise up, and it's around 8.5% here to the line. It gets harder and harder as he turns right into that final rise. What a show from this man, attacking inside the final 15 kilometres and going away on his own to do the job. Alaphilippe with 250 metres still to ride. He knows about these uphill finishes. A two-time winner of the Flèche Wallonne, a couple of times last year at the Tour de France, and it's going to go for him again. The Koenig Quickstep came here looking for wins, unable to do it in their native Belgium, but they have their Frenchman on French roads who is about to pull it right off. Julien Alaphilippe riding away to glory, wins stage 3 in Champagne, and could well go into the yellow jersey. Behind is Craig van Avermaet chasing up for a second place. Jasper Stuyven is there with him as well, while Van Aert in fourth place too. Time ticks on. Remember, it was 31 seconds down, plus the bonuses if you're looking at the yellow jersey for Alaphilippe. Stuyven now taking them to the line. 20 seconds go, 21 seconds go. It's a yellow jersey for Alaphilippe. And in the meantime, it is Matthews in second place. Stuyven was up there on the right in third before Van Avermaet, Sagan and company. So it is victory for Julien Alaphilippe, those 10 bonus seconds, and the yellow jersey, Maillot Jaune, going to Julien Alaphilippe.
Yes, well, what a ride. And of course, Julien Alaphilippe, he was 21 seconds down on Mike Tirrens, and Van Aert was 10 seconds down, so it was actually 21 seconds that he had to make up, because Tunis was out of the equation. But what a ride by Alaphilippe there, to hit out so far. I think a lot of riders were saying, well, he's not going to last out there in this final, which, a team's going to chase it down.
A cheer from everybody involved. Lampard, David Ines, they all played their part to a man today. You even had Elia Viviani working on the front to drill things back as early as they could. They have ultimate confidence in this man. He pulls off victory number 29 of his career, and perhaps with a yellow jersey to go with it, the most special.
Yes, well, I think it's going to be a real special one. He talks about that a lot, as we can see, Mike Tunison coming in. He made the effort. He got very close to that peloton of favourites, which was a group of about 40, 45 riders. He made a big effort, but just He was only a stone throw away. It looked like he was going to make. We could see then when the peloton just pushed on again, he just lost time, big time. But yes, Alaphilippe, this will be a memorable day for him. To take the other jersey, he talked about it in the press, and when he lost that time yesterday in the team times, he said, yes, it's going to be a bit too far, could be too far away. So the tactic was go a bit further out and, pull out an advantage. And yeah, what a ride there in this in the final number of kilometres over that difficult terrain.
Julien Alaphilippe supreme. Second place for Michael Matthews. Third for a very good Jasper Stuyven. And in fourth place, the man who was in the polka dots, of course, Greg van Avermaet. Sagan in the top five. And we've got a new king of the mountains. We have Tim Wellens, who was the animator of the day, moving into the polka dot jersey. All happening at the Tour de France. And we have been mightily entertained. And after so much joy for this man and this team over the weekend, today tinged a little with disappointment that they were unable to hold on to it. As we heard yesterday from Ineos, when you're up against the better team, the better riders, you simply have to take your hat off. And today, the Koenig Quickstep, Julien Alaphilippe, well, they looked unbeatable. Nice little procession in here, at least the last few moments, and the maillot jaune for Mike Tournesen, who tomorrow will go back to lead out jerseys for Dylan Groenewegen. It was a fast stage, an entertaining stage, and one that has given us so much to talk about again going to tomorrow. Of course, amongst all of that, it's easy to forget that Alaphilippe took more bonus seconds on that final bonus sprint as well, so it was easier than perhaps we thought to keep the yellow jersey. Here's Ilnur Zakarin. Wow. Stage wins it will be for him. 3 minutes and 52 with Tanel Kangert coming in that group. And well, if he was targeting stage wins and wanted to lose a bit of time, I'm not sure. Or if maybe he's not feeling so good, and that is just that for the GC for him. We now have the answer. He's out of it, isn't he, now?
Well, we talked about that. Maybe some of the GC men would be in difficulty already in this tour stage, and with the difficulty, as we have seen, it's not surprising that some riders are getting cut out. Zakarin, I don't think he just left the group right away. He just wasn't able to follow, and that is something that riders in the earlier part, this earlier days in this Tour de France, having a difficult stage like this, riders are not in the rhythm yet, and if you're suffering a bit in that way, well then you're open to lose time, as we see Zakarin here.
Came out of the Giro, and a man who's gone out of the yellow jersey, thanks to those who did the work for him. And the final moments in yellow for Mike Tournesen, who will remember his weekend for a long, long time. Double Dutch in Belgium. Today, the Tour returns to its native land, and the Tour today speaks very much the French language. Julien Alaphilippe is a winner, 26 seconds ahead of Michael Matthews, with Stuyven, van Avermaet and Sagan. Alaphilippe wins the stage and takes the yellow jersey. All the reaction coming next with Aura on the Gang.